A pressure and vacuum tester is an essential diagnostic tool that every small engine mechanic should have in their toolbox. However, there is one mistake that so many people make when using this tool that could end up costing you hundreds, if not thousands of dollars in repair bills. I'll also cover what a pressure and vacuum tester actually is, what it does, just how versatile this tool is when it comes to small engine repair and diagnostics, as well as what brands I recommend and what ones I recommend you stay away from. Simply put, this tool will tell you whether the part you're testing holds or leaks air. You can test whether fuel lines have holes or cracks or are leaking. It can test carburetor needles. It can test the gaskets. It can test whether the fuel filter is actually blocked or whether it's passing fuel effectively. Although there are many brands and different makes of pressure and vacuum testers, if your budget stretches, I recommend the Mityvac 8500, and I'll put a link in the description below. There are two reasons why I recommend this model. Firstly, its build quality and the ability for you to be able to take and replace parts as and when they wear out. Secondly, the kit comes with all of the essential parts that you're going to require when pressure and vacuum testing equipment and parts on your small engines. Most tests can be undertaken with the pressure function on one of these gauges, but don't overlook the importance of vacuum as well. Its main role is to test the validity of the crankshaft oil seals in a two-stroke engine. These ensure that no air is coming from the outside of the engine other than what's coming through the carburetor. This ensures that you get a consistent mixture of fuel and air for the engine to run correctly, and it will save it from burning up. The reason we don't use pressure for that specific test is when we push pressure inside of a two-stroke crankcase, it actually forces the sealing lip down and onto the crankshaft, and it can give you a false reading, rather than a vacuum, which will actually lift the seal up and off of that crankshaft and give you the true representation as to the condition and the validity of that seal. The most common mistake I see people make, regardless of their experience with this tool, is they're reading it wrong. The Mityvac has two different scales, and not many people are aware of it. The pressure scale is in pounds per square inch. The vacuum scale is in inches of mercury. Manuals most often recommend, when testing a two-stroke engine, to take that pressure and vacuum to around about 7 to 10 psi. So people will put pressure in, they'll read their gauge, they'll bring it up to 7 to 10 psi, and it will hold and it will be just fine. They then move on to the vacuum test, they'll pull 7 to 10, what they think is psi, but on the Mityvac especially, it's inches of mercury. There are 2 inches of mercury for every 1 psi. That means that if you're using this tool or you have this tool, you have to pull about 15 to 20 inches of mercury to do a valid vacuum test. In this engine here, you can see as I'm pulling 7 inches of mercury, the seals are holding. But as I go up to where it should be, which is around about 15 to 20, you can see that engine is now bleeding down. And that is a perfect example of where someone thinks that they're doing the vacuum test correctly, but actually they're not pulling anywhere near enough vacuum to test those seals. And as I mentioned earlier, it's essential that you have a sealed crankcase in a two-stroke engine, that the only air that comes into that crankcase is through the carburetor itself. Therefore, if you're only pulling 7 to 10 inches of mercury, you think you passed the test, and you put the engine back together, you're only going to find the same issues that you did when you started. And I mentioned at the beginning of this video that this mistake can cost hundreds, if not thousands of dollars. And that's not an exaggeration. A top-end rebuild with OEM parts, you're looking at about 800. That's Australian dollars. And of course, the more expensive the equipment, if you're using something like a Still or a Husqvarna, and the more modern equipment as well, it's going to go much, much higher. And now you know what tool I recommend, where to get it from, how to use it. I've got this video up here that's going to talk you through that process to ensure that you don't make any mistakes when you're testing your equipment at home.